It's possible she has better things to do than let him in, he reflects. She is an icon of platinum perfection, after all, and that must, by any standards, be a busy line of work. But is this her now? Yes, it must be her. Here she comes. And, oddly for a soundtrack, the first note she lets him hear is silent. Not a note, but a quiver of her beauty, smooth and hard and breakable, a lightbulb's beauty, and colder than the moon, with a mix of icy sharpness and soft sensuality. Sun pillars ripple up to frame the sky's entire width in shards of light, a grand proscenium arch. Then cool sun in bright air. Paler air fills the space, and washes of mist smooth light and smoke as twilight grows. Although the playout of her day continues rolling at this fast-forward speed, a single raindrop plummets in slow motion and in close-up. Around the droplet's outline, a tiny rim of light parenthesises it in white. Her night has fallen, lush and glinting in a moon drench of pale, moist stars. Scent of violets in the dark, and he sees she's unfurling all the senses in her soundtrack. Sure enough, the tastes of blood orange and of caramel are rich on his tongue from the moisture in her night air. Still in fast forward as dawn starts glimmering, her sky is soft cracked as the sugar-glazed dome of a doughnut, vanilla smooth and mushroom gold, and Jamie smiles. Before the dawn gathers, she is running through the colour field, but not in any way he's ever known. These are no simple rainbows at night, for this is her own journey. Yes, she transports him from low, hot scarlet up to cool, dark purple, but look, from a pre-dawn sky of red crystal, via amber embers where the clouds glow golden, she leads Jamie Peak through a pink land of coloured smoke and steam beneath a blonde sky. A pale green sun bathes an oil-blue sea. But it must be a faster clock than ever, as the sun now sets once again across the sea, a liquid sunset, death in pink.